I'm Craig, and today for the Surfboard Guide, we're going to check out the Hank Dude by RYD BRAND. So the Hank Dude is a soft or epoxy soft board by RYD BRAND. You might be familiar with the brand. We recently did a review on their first time twin fin. If you haven't had a chance to check it out, we'll put a link in this review. But it's another awesome kind of epoxy soft board they've put out, which is great for a whole range of people. So looking over the Hank Dude, I think it comes in three sizes. I think there's a 6'10", 7'2", and a 7'4". I went smack bang in the middle with a 7'2", and it is 7'2", 23 quarters, 2 5/8, and it is 43.2 liters. So looking over it, I guess it's what you called a kind of a modern performance mid-length. A lot of mid-lengths I've ridden, or like kind of mini mal, or especially in the softboard sort of range, have a lot more kind of width and volume through the nose, a much rounder nose, and kind of hold a wider tail line. So at 7'2", 20 and 3 quarters for a mid-length isn't too wide. So it still definitely has a bit of performance feel. So for someone that can surf and wants to still be able to do turns, this board's pretty good for that. Having a look at it from the side, gentle lift through the nose, nothing crazy. Just probably a pretty kind of classic mid-length rocker. Fairly thrat through the bottom and through the tail, and then just tail lift that's kind of shaped out the back of the tail. So you can get on the back and pivot a little bit. Its volume is through its, like I said, it's not overly wide, so it holds a lot of its volume through its thickness. So it drops away on the rail a little bit more than the first time, so I'm not sure if you checked that out, which was really quite bulky on the rail, but it does have a lot of thickness up here. Like, this is probably much thicker than other mid-lengths at the 7'2" that you get in a performance like fiberglass surfboard. So it does hold a lot of volume here, and that's where it gets a lot of its volume. And then it has this nice little kind of rounded, almost pin, but a round tail to keep it super movable and really, really easy to surf. Flipping it over, I'm not sure what's kind of going on the bottom. Doesn't really feel like too much of the concaves, like maybe a double, and then maybe a bit of a V. It feels like it kind of rises around that center fin, and maybe a double, I'm not really sure, but you know, it didn't really come into play too much. The board just kind of went, you know, it's a soft board, so I'm not getting too deep in concaves and stuff. Whatever's going on here, it works, and it's super easy to surf, super fun, and really easy to paddle. What's cool is, I was saying, it's a soft board on the exterior, but what it is actually quite firm in the center. So I believe its construction is a carbon laminated stringer down the center, an epoxy core, and then it has a 4 ounce layer of glass and a 6 ounce layer of glass, and then it's wrapped in this soft exterior. Apologies if I got that incorrect, but I think that's what it is. So what it does, you get a nice, I don't know if you can hear it, like a donk, like a surfboard kind of knock, but it's just wrapped in a little bit of softness. So why I think this would be good is for someone kind of progressing, you know, off a really soft board and want something a bit firmer so your board's not bending under your feet and getting that more of a performance feel, but you're also a bit worried that maybe a fiberglass board is going to hit you and hurt you or people around you. It's absolutely perfect. So firm, like stiff kind of performance feel, but if it hits you in the head or whatever, probably not going to do as much damage as a, you know, a fiberglass surfboard would. Also, I guess, you know, Australia in summer, the flag's always up. They generally seem to put them in the best sort of spot. So softboards have been epic last few years. They've made them so damn good that I'm completely fine to ride a softboard in the flags when there's little summer peaks, little nor'east wind swells. And I take this down the beach. I can throw my kids on a couple of waves. Wife can have a go. Friends can borrow it. It's a whole bunch of fun. So it's super, super versatile. You'll see we'll put some clips up. From mid-length, the thing turns pretty well. The waves we got were pretty average, but that's generally when I'd kind of ride this. I'm probably not going to take it out when it's pumping, but knowing how it performed, it probably would be fine in much bigger surf, from kind of, you know, 1 foot, which we surfed it in, through to, you know, maybe 6 foot. It's got a, you know, that laminated carbon stringer to keep it really stiff and firm. So it's not going to flex too much. A lot of softboards, when you get them in bigger waves, are going to flex a lot under your feet. They don't really like the pressure of those waves. But this would be absolutely fine. But like I said, for me, it's something I throw in the car in summer when I go to the beach with the family and I want to get some waves in the flags, or just when it's junky. Also, you know, I like softboards. I go for a surf and the waves are, they're good or bad, and I have no expectations about my surf. And a surf with no expectations generally ends up being a pretty fun surf. So yeah, Hank Dude's something I throw in the car for almost any kind of conditions, unless it's pumping and I want to get on a shortboard, and it would work for almost anyone really. RYD BRAND are pretty cool. So with the Hank Dude, they throw in a 2+1 setup. So they give you this 7-inch fiber flex single fin, and they give you the two side bites to go with it. So this felt really good. You can move the single fin up and down to give it like more looseness, give it a tighter feel. You can remove the side bites if you just want a pure single fin feel. And RYD BRAND do a whole bunch of different fins you can put in this board, twins, glass, all that sort of stuff. I also checked out Futures do a T1 in the Thermotech, which is like a half kind of composite fiberglass plastic fin, which is nice and soft, but firmer than like a real plastic fin. And that felt really good. It's an upright twin, had nice pivot, could turn, felt really good. Anything felt fun. I wasn't going to too crazy into it. It's a soft board. It's about having fun. But you can muck around with it, do different fins, give it a different feel. It's completely capable of all that. Overall, the Hank Dude is for almost anyone. If you're looking for a soft board coming into the Australian summer or wherever you are in the world, the thing's absolutely epic. Look, it's loaded with volume that will get you on waves, get your wave count up through the roof. You can battle longboarders, all that sort of stuff in small summer kind of fun waves. It's also great for someone who might be progressing their surfing, wanting to kind of move towards a fiberglass surfboard, and maybe they've been on like, you know, surf school really soft boards and they want something a bit firmer, a bit stiffer, and it has a bit more of a performance feel. The Hank Dude's good for that. As someone who can surf a little bit and like riding shortboards, the Hank board, Hank Dude could turn. You know, there wasn't too much it couldn't do, and I had a whole lot of fun on it. I'd like to thank RYD BRAND for giving us the opportunity to check out the Hank Dude. Absolutely loved it, whole bunch of fun, family loved it, and I'm stoked to get to check it out. And hope you get a chance to check one out too. Thanks so much for watching.